Hello there guys, welcome to Dino's Vault. Welcome to another episode, and you read the title and you know how relevant and how important this video is. I want each and every one of you out there to share this video with as many people as possible. If you are a true biker, if you are a true friend and you really care for your friend, I'm pretty damn sure you will share this video with as many people as possible, because this deals with saving the life of a fellow human being, saving the life of a person. So what is happening here? Just wanted to give you a premise such that you don't get confused. So this was an event organized by MotoWings Hyderabad, one of the riding group here whom I'm closely associated with. I was invited as a chief guest there, but that's not the main point here. The main point is to spread awareness about road safety, and just in case someone gets involved in an accident, what you and I can do to make sure that the person stays alive until medical help arrives. So the main important do's and don'ts, it's not only what you do, but more importantly, it's what you're not supposed to do to make sure that you do not cause more harm to the already inflicted patient or person who's lying on the road. So this session was conducted by GVK EMRI team, and Dr. Madhusudan Rao is the one who's taking the session. So please watch till the very end of this video, and please try and share it with as many people as possible, such that we can save as many lives as possible using these techniques. And together, let's try and make this world a better and a safer place. Let's go ahead right into the session.
So we run 108 ambulance services, emergency medical services, not only in Telangana, in Andhra Pradesh, almost pan India, in 60 states and two union territories in India. We run emergency medical services. As part of the social responsibility, we conduct a first responder training program. So who is the first responder, first of all? If any emergency happens, the first person who responds to that emergency, may be me or you or somebody else, that person is called as first responder. Okay? So in case of emergency, who renders and help? First aid, it is, the person is called as first responder. So, as you all of you on the road, biker, you have a passion in your heart for the racing or biking, okay? So the first thing, what we heard here, so far all the speakers are talking about the safety, right? Safety is the first step, and taking care of the person who is injured is the second step. So we work on two principles. One is golden hour, and the second one is platinum 10 minutes. Golden hour means the minute or the moment the accident or the incident happened, from there and then onwards till 1 hour, it is called as golden hour. If we give some kind of first aid to that person or to the patient, the survival rates will increase dramatically. And the first, and then platinum 10 minutes. Initially, within 10 minutes of the incident or the accident, if we can, you know, render help to that patient, the survival rates increase double fold. Okay. So, during your racing, maybe, you know, your biking experience, you might have so many persons met with an accident, or breaking legs, or, you know, broken arms, or, you know, sprained or dislocated joints. Okay, so anything, whenever there is a bleeding, first stop the bleed first. Stopping the bleeding is very important, because once the blood come out of the body, it is very difficult to get blood from other person, and so we need to draw the blood, testing means we need to test the grouping, and for the any contamination or infectious diseases. And then we will start the fresh blood to the injured person. So it will take at least 1 hour of time. So within 1 hour, anything can happen. So first, any injury, our motto should be stop the bleeding. So as part of this, we conduct active bleeding control project for auto drivers and bikers. Okay, how to stop the bleeding? First of all, if anybody met with an accident, if they are bleeding, whether it is a small bleed, big bleed, doesn't matter, stop the bleed first. So to stop the bleed, there are four ways. One is direct pressure. Simple and direct one, or simple and effective method is direct pressure. Before going to stop any bleeding, first of all, your safety first. Your safety is always comes first. Okay. So your safety means you need to check in two sides. Your safety from the physical damage. Maybe you are working on a road, means you are helping a person on the road, middle of the road. There will be ongoing traffic will be there. If that is an accident scene, and if that is an accident scene, there might be chances of fuel leakage and explosion chances are there. So take care of that aspect of the safety. And second safety is from the infectious diseases. So any person, any body fluid, whether it is a blood or any body fluid coming out of the other person's body, always take care that don't touch the body fluids, maybe blood or something else. Okay. So to avoid the touching, use gloves. If you are not able to get gloves, okay, so take a cloth or something and keep that folded cloth on the injury and keep the pressure at least for 10 minutes because our blood clotting time is 10 to 20 minutes. Some people's blood will clot within 10 minutes, some people will blood will take 15 minutes. So at least you need to keep the pressure for 10 minutes. If it is not stopping, then apply pressure bandage, means tie with a roller gauze tightly, and then if it then raise the head, leg or hand above the heart level of the patient so that the elevation will decrease the pressure and it will decrease the bleeding time. And last one is tourniqueting. Tourniquet means if somebody is badly hurt, maybe broken bone, literally hanging, okay, take a cloth and fold it one inch width like this. If the bleed is here, just above 3 to 4 inches above, okay, tie the cloth like this very tightly means till you see visible inspection, till the bleed stops. This is called tourniqueting. Once you tourniquet, write the time when you tourniqueted. It is now 9:15. You tourniqueted at 9:15 a.m. 23rd 6th, because once the patient went to the hospital, so once he tourniqueted, what will happen? The blood will stop. Blood flow will stop. If the blood flow will stop, the rest of the body parts won't get blood supply. If the hand won't get blood supply within 2 hours, the cells starts dying. That means hand literally starts dying. So to prevent that, for every half an hour, we need to just loose the tourniquet and again tie it. Loose the tourniquet, again tie it. Okay. So in these 4 steps, direct pressure, pressure bandage, and elevation, and last one is tourniquet. So with these 4 steps, we can stop the bleed. It will help a lot to the patient. Okay. And if time permits, and if we have a zeal, donate your blood also. You can donate for every 3 months, almost 350 ml. Okay. So if you donate blood, it will help other persons. Maybe from the one person's blood, we can make almost around 12 products which are useful for the sick people, injured people in case of emergency. Maybe whole blood, maybe plasma, maybe platelets, maybe only RBC, okay, only plasma. There are different things which we use in the hospitals to save the sick and injured persons. And one more thing is cervical spine. Okay, you are all telling about the helmet. Yeah? Why helmet? In our body, any part can be repaired and replaced also. If something happened to the heart, we can replace it. If lungs are going bad, we can replace it. If liver is going bad, we can replace it or repair it. But in our body, we cannot replace our brain and we cannot repair our brain. Any damage to the brain and the spinal cord is a permanent damage. Nobody in this world can repair it. So, you all know Michael Schumacher? Yeah? You all know Michael Schumacher? Who is that?
Formula One racer.
Formula One racer, yes. Where is he now? Where is he? You heard about recently, about him? No. Because I'll tell the what happened to him. In 2015, he met with an accident. So he went for holiday in Switzerland, and in Switzerland he is doing skiing. You know skiing, no? That with paddles, they ski on the ice. So in that he rolled down on a slope, and immediately ambulance came. They took him to the good hospital where everything was done, scanning, etc. And with his broken leg and broken arm, was taken care of. Taken care of that. But on third day, he started complaining of numbness in the legs and weakness in the hands. So then they realized that there is something wrong with the cervical spine. Cervical spine means neck spine. This is neck. So this is the spinal cord will start from the brain and goes to downwards. So during that accident, he broke his cervical spine. The cervical spinal injuries are very dangerous because the pain is very less. Along with the cervical spine, if there is a broken hand, this pain is severe than this. And the symptoms will start very slowly. Okay? So by the time doctors realized that he has a broken cervical spine, time up. Now he is in vegetative state. Vegetative means he can listen, he can talk, he can hear you, he can see you, he can react, but he cannot move his hands, he cannot move his legs, and he cannot feel any pain on the below the neck, and no control on the bowels, no control on the urine. He is like a vegetable. I think recently one movie, also Telugu movie came, Nagarjuna, that Upiri. Yeah? So same thing happened to Michael Schumacher. C collar, cervical collar will be there, applied. He might have, you know, maybe now he is racing. Because of the negligence, a big Switzerland government ordered a big inquiry. Why it was neglected, C collar was neglected in case. So, as a rule of thumb, remember any injury above the clavicle, collarbone. Above the collarbone, remember, take care of the cervical spine. Okay? If you are helping a person who met with an accident, maybe he is having a helmet, no injury to the head. But because of the speed, what happens? Whiplash injury will happen. Means the head will come out like this and goes back. So at that time, this spine will be stretched and comes back like a rubber band. So in that scenario, the cervical spine also injury happens. At that time, what we can do is, if you call for 108 ambulance, in the ambulance there will be cervical collar. But it is a very far off place, it will take much time to ambulance to reach. So at that time, what we can manually stabilize the neck. How we can manually stabilize the neck is, take a long clock, any clock, okay? This is called cervical collar, okay? This thing is called a cervical collar. And this will be applied like this. Like this. We can apply like this. So what happens? He cannot move his hand. The weight of the head will be transferred directly to the shoulder with this plastic thing. So weight will be reduced on the cervical spine, and this will not allow any movement. And when we are shifting the patient also, generally how we will shift, they catch hold of the legs and the hands, and they push, literally they pull and drag the patient. At that time also the head will be intact, the cervical spine will be intact. So if this thing is not available. We can manually improvise ourselves. Okay? So how we can manualize the even manually immobilize like this. Okay? So like this. So that it doesn't move. The head won't move like that. Okay? If the head is not moving, spine will not move. So the spine will be in a straight line. Though it is injured, it will be in a inline, means in a straight line, so that there will be no injury. Yeah,
you can come here so that you can have a view of this demo.
Come closer if you can,
come,
guys.
Come closer to the dais.
So you can have a better view.
Yeah, see, like this. If we immobilize cervical spine like this, the person's neck will be, you know, stabilized, so that no injury. So it should be like, you need to carry the patient whenever, if you are carrying the patient also, one person should hold the neck like this. And transfer, if you are transporting in your own transport, okay, you need to manage like this. And if you are, if ambulance comes, the ambulance EMT will be, the paramedic will be there, the paramedic knows how to handle it, and they will have that. And one more thing in the ambulance is, we have a spine board. One board will be there, on the board we will carry that patient without causing any extra damage to the spinal cord. And next thing is about the cardiac arrest. Okay, in case of cardiac arrest, what we need to do? Yeah, so how we'll know about the cardiac arrest? Nobody is, you know, excused from the cardiac diseases nowadays. Okay, maybe lifestyle. Okay, lifestyle, because of lifestyle, because of any habits, or hereditary from the family, passed on from the family. Okay, so how we'll know about the cardiac arrest? Ela telustadi? So suddenly a person is talking like me and suddenly collapsed. First of all, what we need to do is check the response. First of all, first thing is always make sure that your safety is first comes. If you are helping somebody, you are your safety first. If you are safe, we can help. Otherwise, we cannot risk our life to somebody else. Okay, always your safety first. Two things, mechanical and biological also. Okay, so first what we will check the response.
Hello sir, are you okay? Can you hear me? Hello sir.
Like that we will check the response. Okay, and then if the person is not responding, responding means whether it is verbal, okay, he wakes up and he says something, or he just has a movement, or some, you know, some kind of noise is coming out of his mouth, it is okay. If nothing is there, that means his life, the person's life is in danger. Okay, immediately what we can do?
Call for help.
Call for help. You can call 108 by dialing 108 in your phone. If you are alone, keep it in speaker mode, call 108 and ask for help. Or if you have any help, ask, sir, can you call 108? Okay, they'll call. And then check the carotid pulse. Carotid means, see, all of you take your two fingers. Yeah? So in your, on your throat, there is a ring-like structure here. Okay? On the ring-like structure, towards your hand, just 1 inch towards your hand, draw like this. And press here, you feel a pulse. Right? That is called as carotid. The carotid means that artery supplies blood from the heart to the brain. Okay, this is the major thing. There will be two carotids, left and right. Never palpate, means never touch both arteries like this. Okay, if we, for a brief 5 seconds blood flow is stopped to the brain, the patient will collapse. Okay, so check the carotid pulse. How much time? 10 seconds, at least for 10 seconds. Keep your fingers and feel for the pulse for 10 seconds. So, count yourself in your heart. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10. No pulse, then it is a dangerous. And whenever you are checking the pulse, look for the chest rise with your eyes. If the chest is rising, okay, or not rising. So no pulse, not responding, and no breathing means the person is collapsed, the heart is stopped. In that scenario, if you witnessed that, mana mundu jariginam, hamara samne hua, so immediately what we can do is we can save the life. What we can do is we start the CPR. CPR means cardiopulmonary resuscitation. Cardiopulmonary resuscitation. So like that, we need to press on the chest. Where you need to press on the chest? In the middle of the sternum. There is a flat bone in our chest. Yeah. So between two nipples. Okay. Draw an imaginary line like this. And from the middle of the throat, draw an imaginary line. So here, where the both intersect. Okay. Keep your heel of the palm. Not entire palm. Only heel of the palm. Here. And press hard. How much? At least the chest should go 2 inches down. It will go. Initially you will hear crackling sounds from within 1 or 2 press. You will hear the crackling. That is okay. No issues. Because if you break your fingers like this, you will hear sound. Like that you will hear a crackling sound. That is entirely good. Then press hard and leave. Hard, leave. Push hard, fast. Push hard and fast. How much fast? At least your speed should be 100 to 120 compressions per minute. Okay? So like that you need to compress 30 compressions. Okay? So if you have a mask like that, you can use that mask or any barrier between you and the patient, like a hanky or any cloth. Okay? Patient, mouth and nose. Close the nose and blow air into the patient, that person's mouth. So the, and whenever you are blowing the air, look for the chest rise, whether chest is rising or not. So to blow the air, what we need to do is just lift the head like this. Because, so everybody touch your chin to chest like this. Try to breathe. Yeah, now look up and breathe. Which one is easier? Yeah. So if the person is collapsed, that is why during sleeping we snore. Why we snore? All are in snoring club. Yeah. Everybody is in snoring club. You don't know. Your family members, you are married, your wife, okay, or your brother or sister knows. Okay. So why we snore? Our tongue goes down like this into the throat, and it will vibrate along with our exhaled and inhaled air. Okay, that is why we snore. Right? So, to prevent that, what we need to do is just extend the head like this. So that tongue will come up and air will go into the lungs freely. So, we can do CPR like that. How much time? Till definite help comes. Or till you reach the hospital. Don't stop in between. Once you start the CPR, don't stop. Sometimes some patients will come out with 2 minutes, means 30 to 2, like that. 5 cycles of CPR, some people will come back. Immediately they start coughing and then they'll get their consciousness back. Some people, it will take much time, especially young people, children. Okay, electric shock people, somebody got electrocuted. Most of the deaths happen because of the electric shock is heart cardiac arrest. Okay, if you start CPR immediately, they will come back. Okay, and sir, one more thing, in accidents, cardiac arrest happens because of the bleeding. If the internal injury, internal bleed or external bleeding, okay, if the most of the blood comes out of the blood vessels, cardiac arrest will happen. Then also, if you do CPR, they'll come back again. Okay, so
what is the interval, like chest press and the mouth to mouth resuscitation?
Yeah, good. So 30 compressions and 2 breaths. You need to complete in 18 seconds.
Okay, 30 chest compressions.
30 compressions and 2 breaths, 18 seconds.
Okay, so that should be repeated.
You repeated until you reach the hospital.
Okay.
or until a definite help comes.
And
maybe an ambulance.
We should wear some kind of barrier.
Barrier in the mouth. Whenever you are blowing air into the patient's mouth.
Okay.
Okay. It is a barrier to protect you from the infectious
diseases.
Okay. Infectious diseases. Okay. My concern is infectious diseases. Maybe there might be some contagious diseases will be. You know about the TB, right? Yes. So TB is transmitted through breath, right? You know about the HIV. You know about the hepatitis B. Okay, these are all the contagious diseases which are hard to treat. Okay, so that is why we need to take care of the body fluids. So do not directly touch the any body fluids, maybe blood, maybe semen, whatever. Okay, if you accidentally touch any body fluid, immediately wash with soap and water or use any sanitizer. Okay, immediately. And one more thing will be there, you might have saw in any big malls, offices, even airports, railway station, or even in the flight also, there is an equipment called AED. This is AED. Okay? In case of cardiac arrest, generally how our heart beats? Love, duck. Right? But, sometimes for some people, for some reasons, what happens? The heart just shakes like this. To stop that shaking, what we need to do is, it is a reversible cause, means where we can make the difference, where we can save the life. So we need to give a shock to the, I take shock to that patient. So to give that shock, we cannot give direct, alternate current, means what current we use, electricity we use. It needs a DC, direct current shock, battery shock. So this equipment is called as AED, Automated External Defibrillator. Okay, defibrillation means shaking. So, it is very easy to use, user friendly. Once you start it, switch on it, it will start prompting you what you need to do next step.
Apply pads to patient's bare chest. Plug in pads connector next to flashing light.
Even on the pads also, it is they come printed, which pad goes where. See, this pad goes where? Here.
Apply pad. Plug in
here,
connector.
This one, here.
Analyzing heart rhythm.
What it is saying? Analyzing heart.
Don't touch the patient. Analyzing interrupted. Do not touch the patient. Shock advised.
Shock advised.
Charging. Stay clear of patient.
Everybody clear?
Deliver shock now. Press the orange button now.
So this button will blink. Now it is not ever visible because of that.
Shock delivered.
Pause. So once the shock is delivered, what happens? The heart will stop. Immediately we need to start the CPR. Like the compressions in the neck to start. So the AED is very user friendly. Anybody who can understand this, manufactured in US, that is it speaks in English. If it is manufactured in India, it starts speaking in our languages. Okay? Just follow the commands, that's it. It will save the life. So these AEDs are available. If you happen to board the flight from the back end, you can see there will be written as AED, one box. Okay? And in the malls, airports, in the office buildings, AED is mandatory. According to the GHMC guidelines, any office space above 100 capacity, AED is mandatory. Okay, so this will save the life, and CPR also will save the life. So CPR, it is very simple technique where we can make a difference, where we can save your life. Saving life is very, joyful thing. Once they came back, it is very, it gives satisfaction. Yes, I saved your life. And one more thing is, you are all familiar with broken bones, sprains, dislocations, strains, right? So what we need to do in case of a strain, what you will do? Sprain, you know, So we are walking, just leg got ankle sprain, or elbow sprain, or ankle sprain. What we will do? Remember, rise. R-I-C-E, rise. Any sprain, first rest that part. If it is a leg or hand, don't walk on the leg, give a complete rest. Okay? Next one is compression bandage. Apply a compression bandage. Okay? In any medical store, in the first aid kit, there will be a compressed crepe bandage. It comes as a pink color bandage. Apply that. And immobilization. Immobilization means do not allow to move. Okay? And last one is ice. So ice, take ice cubes, put it in a cloth and keep on the affected area for 10 minutes and remove for 10 minutes to come back early. Okay? And in case of broken bones, right? You can use splints, any splint. You can use anybody. Yeah.
Anybody.
Yeah, anybody?
You can pick anybody.
Sir. Yeah, please come. Anybody volunteers?
There's a quick demo which will happen on you. So anybody please. Who would like to volunteer?
Srivardhan. The basic rule is we need to immobilize before the injury joint and above the injury joint. We need to make lock, right? We can use as a splint anything. You can use a manual, you can use anything. You can use a blanket, towel, anything. Our main purpose is immobilization. It prevents bleeding and it reduces the pain and it salvages the limb. So we'll demonstrate you.
No. Even you can use a book also, magazine. Okay, you can use a book.
For example,
and hold it
this,
and you can keep
this person having a fracture at the radial ulnar bone, we need to cover this joint, wrist and elbow. We need to cover with the splint. If there is a bleeding, we control bleeding with a direct pressure. We can use some gauze pads, gauze rolls, control it. Then we have to roller band. We need to use roller bandage from distal to proximal. Distal to proximal means below to the above. We start from here and we'll go above. Okay, in case of collarbone fracture or humerus fracture, we need to use sling. It is a very easy.
Do keep that on your hand and reach home. Let's see what your parents react like.
And if that kind of sling is not available, splint it and open one or two buttons and keep hand like this. Okay?
So it is, on the road, this kind of sophisticated things are not available. Okay? So with any cloth, splint it and open one button. Or if it is a t-shirt, make a small cut and keep it like this, center to the body. Always any broken bone, center to the body. Okay? So, what happens if it is hanging like this? Maybe, somebody touches like this. Or he is walking, something hits him. So, what happens? Pain will increase and another damage. Okay? So, always splint and sling. These things, what happens if you splint and sling it, it will give protection to the injured area and it will reduce the recuperating time means recovery time, it will reduce the recovery time
and it will avoid the suturing. So broken bones, what happens if you leave it, the broken bones will move like this. So along with the bone inside the body, artery, vein and muscles will be there. If they got cut, definitely the person needs a surgery. Okay, open up and repair the damaged things and again close. So unnecessary waste of money, waste of time. Okay, so to avoid that, splint this. Splint any body part, maybe a hand or leg or whatever. Splint and keep central to the body and as close possible to the body, so that it will reduce the recovery time. Okay, splinting. And in a sprain also, same. Rest. Okay, rise. Good, thank you.
Hello. Sir, RISE stands for rest, ice, compression.
Compression
elevation.
Elevation.
Yeah.
If you are sitting or sleeping, keep your hand or leg on an elevated platform. If you are sitting, keep on an opposite chair. Or sleeping, keep one or two pillows under the leg.
Sir, I have one.
Yes, sir.
For the heart, what you explained, na, CPR and all.
Mm.
In that case, I just want to know if the person has been bypassed, like. Senior citizen.
Yes.
So what can we give that CPR to them or I don't know.
Perfectly. You can give. Okay. Whether it is a bypass surgery or open heart surgery, whatever, we can, we need to do CPR. Even in the hospital also, it happens, we do. Okay. So forget about the this thing. Huh? Okay. And CPR. And last thing is choking. I'll tell you about the choking. You heard about choking?
Yeah.
You heard about anybody choking? Yeah? So you are eating something or somebody is eating something like a piece of meat or a roti or something else. Suddenly it got obstructed here. What we can do? How we will relieve the choking?
Normally
it is a life-threatening situation. If we do something, the person will live. Otherwise he will die because the airway is closed. So what we can do is, yes, any volunteer?
Yes,
come. Yeah.
So, okay. He is eating something and suddenly got choked here.
Okay.
Generally, what we will do is, we will touch the throat. We will do like this. That is normal, our automatic reaction. Okay,
both
hands. This is called universal sign of choking. What we need today is, if the patient, if this person is choking and he is doing like this, you cannot say he is choking, but this sign will tell you that something is wrong with that person. So immediately go him, sir, are you choking? If he says yes sir, kuch atak gaya mera kondulo irukundi sir annadu, it is not true choking. Okay, it is okay if they are speaking. If the person is not able to speak, ask him to cough up forcibly. Cough up. Khasi karne ke liye bol, tagadani cheppandi. Okay, if it comes out, it is okay. No, then go behind. Okay, go behind the victim like this person and with your dominant hand, keep, make your fist like this.
I'll show you.
Okay, not like this. Okay, and keep the dominant hand on the belly,
just above the belly button.
Okay, three fingers above the belly button, and another hand on the this thing, hands, my fist. Okay, and give upward thrust. Okay, like this. So what happens? It is very painful procedure, but it saves the life. Okay. So if I do like this, the pressure will compress the lungs. The remaining air in the lungs will try to come out forcibly, dislodging the choking object. Okay? You need to do till it comes out, or till the person becomes unconscious. If the person becomes unconscious, slowly put him on the floor. Why I am keeping my leg here is, if this person becomes unconscious, it is a support for me. Okay, if I am standing like this, if he is falling, I cannot manage his weight. So that is always keep your leg here. And if it is he is falling on me, I can take care of. He is falling to front, I can hold him. Okay? And keep him on the floor and start compressions till you reach the hospital. In the hospital, there is a scope will be there. We'll keep the scope and remove with the forceps. Okay? So, it is a life-saving technique which saves the life. Right? And one more thing is, this is for adult. If it's a small child, go to their level on your knees. Okay? If it is more than small child, infant, maybe this much age. Yeah? This much age. These fellows will have a very bad habit of keeping everything in the mouth, right? If they keep it in the mouth, this one or everything, whatever, they crawl on the floor, on the bed, and they keep everything in the mouth. And what we give with love, a chocolate, a candy, a jelly, okay, they are also hazardous. If they are choking, how we can recognize it, they stop crying. This fellow's language is crying. They stop crying and their face will become blue. That means something is obstructing the throat. Immediately take the baby into your hand. Like this. Hold the baby like this. See, I'm not closing mouth and nose. Mouth and nose are open. And this, I'm keeping my fingers on the bony part here. Okay? And hold the baby like this. And one leg in your axilla, like this side. Okay? Sit on the bench. Or something, or a bed, okay? So with the support you will tie, head should be downwards like this, in a slant position, give 5 back blows, like this, front, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? And then turn the baby into this hand, and see, if it is visible, remove this, if it is not visible, no blind scoping. Okay, so not it didn't came to with the 2 fingers in the middle of the chest, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times, then see, no, again same, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay. So once the baby it comes out, excellent, no problem. If it didn't came, the baby will become limp, very, you know, the collapse means heart is stopped. Okay, immediately what we do is with your 2 fingers in the middle of the chest, you hold the baby forehead like this and keep on pressing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, like that, 30 compressions and give 2 breaths. 30 compressions, 2 breaths. And by doing this, you go to hospital, they remove the obstruction, okay, the baby will be saved. Losing a baby is very, you know, physically and emotionally very tough, right? But with a simple techniques, we can save the life, choking. It is a preventable death. These 2 are very preventable deaths and where you can make the difference. Yeah? Okay. So any questions you want to ask? Any questions?
How to know when to give that AED?
AED, if any person collapsed, okay, not responding, you tapped him, he's not responding, attach the AED. Okay, it will tell you whether to give shock. If not shockable, it will tell you no shock is advised. Okay, if not shock is not advised, pulse is there, pulse here, check the pulse. If pulse is there, take him to the hospital, no pulse, start CPR.
So, okay. AED happens before CPR or during CPR?
First, whatever comes first. If AED is immediately available there, okay. Attach it.
Okay.
Okay, and start CPR. If AED is somewhere down the in the canteen, it will take time to bring that.
Meanwhile, you
start
those.
The CPR. Okay? So, starting CPR is very important because whatever you do, our brain requires continuous supply of blood. Okay? So, if blood flow is stopped for 4 minutes to the brain cells starts dying slowly. After 8 minutes, permanent damage. To prevent that damage, we do CPR. So, by doing CPR, what we are doing, we are pressing the heart. Heart will pump out the blood. So that circulation, blood circulation will reach the brain.
Understood?
So both has to be done simultaneously. If both are like, if we are while doing CPR, in between we are supposed to use the AED or?
Yes, I am doing CPR. If you brought the AED, you start attaching. Whenever it says don't touch the patient, I'll stop the CPR. Okay. I'll stop the CPR. That's it. Okay. And then once the shock is over, again CPR.
Okay.
And no need to remove the pads also.
Okay.
Keep on doing CPR. Whenever the time 2 minutes are over, it will tell you stop CPR. Okay. So keep on going. Keep on going. Good. And any questions?
Tell your good name.
My good name is Madhusudan. My name is Madhusudan and he is Mr. Rasul.
Do you have any online source where same all this thing is stored or available?
Stored means?
In a video format or in a demonstration format?
Demonstration, this is just what I demonstrated you, I told you, I lectured you. Just as a part of our program. Small, it is a 1 day program. It is a 1 day program. Around 6 hours of program. First responder training program. Okay, if you are a 30 member team, we'll come and teach you and
brief us.
Yeah, demonstrate you techniques. Or if you come to our campus, we will do. Our campus is in Machel Road. Okay, GVK EMRI. We will teach you over there.